Twitch streamer Kai Cenat's promise PlayStation giveaway ultimately landed him in police custody when thousands of young people mobbed the streets of New York City, leaving destruction in their path. The NYPD showed up in riot gear to disperse the crowds, seen jumping on cars, throwing punches, and hurling various objects at others.
Twitch streamer Kai Cenat has been charged with inciting a riot and unlawful assembly after thousands of his fans rioted in Manhattan's Union Square following the streamer's announcement of PlayStation 5 and $100 gift card giveaways. Now, just to give you some more details on what happened, Cenat promoted the giveaways on his Instagram story, telling everyone that the event would take place at 4 p.m. on Friday. According to the NYPD's highest ranking uniformed police officer, Jeffrey Madry, about 300 people had gathered by 1:30 p.m. And that volume of people is what is expected usually when an online influencer does something like this. But by 3 p.m., thousands of people had already arrived at Union Square. Soon the scene became pretty unruly, as you can see in the video, and Cenat had to be removed from the park by police for safety reasons. At least two officers and four civilians were taken to the hospital in ambulances, while another officer suffered a broken hand. And look, there were some reports alleging that a 17-year-old boy had been shot, but those reports were unfounded and untrue. So in case you came across those false reports, I wanted to correct the record on that. Just to give you a few more details, people in the park threw paint cans, bottles, and rocks, while others walked around with shovels, axes, and other tools from nearby construction sites. Some in the crowd, the police chief added, lit fireworks during the chaos. And he said one or two police officers had to be removed from the crowd because of injuries. Now, Cenat did not take out the proper permits for this event, which is part of the reason why he ended up getting arrested. We can have a discussion about whether or not he should face charges in just a moment. Few more details though. During a short stream inside a vehicle near Union Square on Friday, Cenat flashed a fistful of what he said were $100 gift cards held in a brown CVS paper bag to give away. He was quoted as saying, "They're throwing tear gas out there." He said that in a Twitch stream while the chaos was unfolding. "We're not going to do nothing until it's safe. Everybody for themselves, because it's a war out there, man." But then literally seconds later, he exits the vehicle, but was immediately swarmed by people, his fans, and he was shortly taken out of that situation by authorities because of how unsafe the situation was. But I also want to note that there was a moment where he was trying to get the crowd to chill out. So I wanted to show you that evidence as well. Let's take a look. So he's trying to get them to chill, but at that point, you literally have thousands of people there. It's really hard for them to even hear what he's saying. It's hard for us to hear what he's saying. So the situation became unruly, out of control. Cenk, what do you think?
I think it's complicated and it's nuanced. So I'm gonna go in a couple of different directions here. So first of all, I think it's terrible news, and I think it's great news for reasons that I'll explain. In terms of who should be charged, everyone who broke the law should be charged. I don't think that's complicated at all. What are you stomping on cars, stealing from vendors, attacking people? That's crazy. Of course you should be charged for those things. On the other hand, I don't think that Kai Cenat himself should be charged at all. He had no idea that many people were gonna show up. And they said, we did events before and we get a lot of people to show up, but nothing like this. This is thousands upon thousands. We didn't anticipate it. So he didn't get proper permits. He didn't think he needed a permit. He thought he was just gonna do a giveaway for, maybe a couple hundred people. And in New York, that could be a problem, but probably not, right? And so it just got more viral than he expected. I don't think that's a thing that you put somebody in prison over. So I'm curious what you think about that, and then I'll get to the why it's terrible and great news.
Yeah, well, let me give you some more information on arrest, because dozens of people were arrested. Many of those individuals were minors. Police arrested 66 people, according to the Washington Post, including 30 juveniles. And that's according to a spokesperson from the police department. Cenat was arrested and charged with riot, inciting to riot, and unlawful assembly. If he's convicted of all three charges, he could be sentenced to 5 years in prison. He is scheduled to appear in court on August 18th. I largely agree with you. I don't think he expected the kind of crowd that showed up. And once that crowd is there, if he were urging them to riot, that would be a different story. But clearly, I don't think he expected it. He wasn't inciting a riot. Inciting a riot is encouraging, you know, all these people to do what they did. But I also agree that those who injured others, engaged in violence, you know, randomly decided to destroy other people's properties and cars and things like that, they should face charges for that. We'll see what happens with these 66 people who have been arrested. I'm really curious what you think the good news in this is.
Yeah, so look, the terrible news is that in this case, I don't think Kai meant for there to be a riot in the ways that we've described here. I say Kai like I know him, I don't. I'm just saying this guy's name. And so on the other hand, now that he got this much attention for it, the next streamer is going to intend it. And because they're like, man, look at how much his name got on the news. So it's too tempting, it's too tempting. I guarantee you there'll be a lot more of this. People are doing, oh, I did get a giveaway. Oh, did I do it in the middle of giant traffic and cause a huge mess? I guess my name's going to be all over the media. So that's the terrible news. The good news is that this can be used for good. So we asked people to show up in the middle of Iowa once for a speech I gave, 600 people showed up. So now imagine if we got these kind of crowds, several thousand people, but we did it for political reasons. And we did it not to riot, not to cause anyone harm, but to ask for accountability. I know it seems, well, yeah, they give you when you give away PS5, the people will do it, but for politics, they won't do it. Hold, I bet they will, and I bet it'll move the country. So that's my sense of it. I know it's very hard to believe right now, but that's what I'm gonna go for, to be honest.
Yeah, I mean, look, I'm in a pessimistic kind of mood. So I think that the idea that you can draw that kind of large crowd, first of all, I would be uncomfortable with wanting to draw a crowd like that for accountability, for political reasons.
Well, I'm not at all uncomfortable with it.
Okay, but it could easily become unruly and.
But so that's a good point. And what did we do in Iowa and everywhere we've ever gone? You remember all the places, Miami, all the debates, the speeches we gave outside, etc. We brought in a different guy, Kai Newkirk, who's part of the progressive movement, to teach nonviolence and non-confrontation and how to make sure that you don't get into physical. Now you can say, hey, look, we're the gold standard because we bothered to do that with people that come. This guy's a streamer and he's young and he didn't know to do that, right? So I'm not trying to blame him for that. But Anna, I'm not saying, hey, let's just show up and see what happens, right? We're gonna do the exact opposite of what the right wing does. We're gonna make sure that we teach people, do not get physical.
I know, but I don't know. I think that he was able to draw the kind of crowd that he drew because he was gonna give stuff away.
For sure.
In particular, yeah. Gaming consoles that are highly popular, highly prized, gift cards. That's why thousands of people showed up.
Yeah,
so
but you know,
do I think thousands of people could show up for a political cause? Maybe, right? Yeah. But the way that you organize that is really, really important. And you gotta be super careful in how you do it. You gotta be super careful with the rhetoric you use when you're planning something like that. And even so, in order to affect actual change, it can't just be a one-time, we're gonna protest and then we're gonna go home. It needs to be organized, persistent pressure toward elected lawmakers with a clear message in what the policy accomplishments need to be.
Yeah, look, it's not easy, guys, because it involves infrastructure. Once you know it involves infrastructure, it involves money, right? And so if you wanna do an unruly protest, it doesn't cost a thing, right? But if you wanna do a protest where you're a little bit careful about how things go and make sure that things go in the right direction, yeah, it costs money. And so that's, you know, we gotta build up the resources to be able to do that. But once we do, no, I want that times 10. But not without, not the physical stuff, not the violence, but to, yes, have an accountability. And the good news when we do it is that we're definitely gonna have a strategy. So there's a lot of folks out there in the political world and non-political world that don't have a clue, that don't believe in strategy, don't even understand that you're supposed to have a strategy. It is supposed to end, in our case, with passing bills. If you're not doing it to pass bills, you're doing it for other reasons like getting famous, getting paid, whatever. And that's not interesting at all. And it's totally pointless, right? But we use people power to drive towards actual bills, then it makes all the difference. Last thing on this is, yeah, sure, PS5 costs a decent amount of money, but if you got $20,000 in student debt, that's a lot more money. So the only reason people wouldn't show up for that is if they think there's no hope, because politicians are so crooked, so corrupt. Even if 20,000 of us or 200,000 of us showed up, they still wouldn't do anything. And there is legitimacy to that point of view. But let's show up a couple of times and see what happens. So wait for it, we're not ready yet. But when we are, come join us for how to do this right.
Final thing I'll say about this is, look, I haven't seen the numbers for myself. I'm going based off the reporting in the Washington Post. It's also been repeated in other outlets that he gets paid hundreds of thousands of dollars a month just to stream himself sleeping.
Look, this, it's not our world. So we're on Twitch, and we have plenty of great programming on Twitch and YouTube and all these other platforms, obviously. But like streamers that are predominantly talk about video games, play video games, etc. I don't want to be a boomer and be like, I don't get it.
I get the video games, yeah, for sure.
Yeah, it's absolutely like commentators about sports, etc. So they're modern day talk show hosts. So I do get it, right? But as they're doing that on Twitch in particular, it incentivizes them to stay on for long stretches of time. And when you're staying on for 8, 10, 12 hours, brother's gonna take a nap at some point. And then people still watch. I don't know why they still watch.
I think
that's the part that's amazing.
Yeah, I mean, look, I think it's more about the community, because his viewers aren't just watching him sleep. They're engaging with one another in the chat. So I'm just gonna assume that's what the draw actually is. Otherwise, I don't know, people just like to watch this guy sleeping, and I think that's a little creepy. Just keep it real.
But remember, that's a tiny part of what he does. Okay, that is not why he got famous.
Yes.
And if you're in the old school crowd, just, it's super easy to understand. Current day streamers are basically like Johnny Carson and Jay Leno. They're just the new talk show hosts. That's all. And some of them are a tiny bit political, most of them are not. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.